Hello everyone, welcome back. Dope on a Rope here, carrying on from where we left off. It was hiding in a bedroom, waiting for morning. It's now morning. So let's carry on and see. Oh yeah, 6 o'clock, so we should get an episode on the TV. Hopefully that'll give me some skill progression in something. Anytime now. Oh, here we go. Cook. All right, cooking. Not the worst, not the best, but shouldn't complain. Right. Take the magazines, stick them in my fanny pack. Right. So today, I need to get Molotov cocktails. So I will grab some more water. Keep those because I haven't come across an empty gas can, unfortunately. Right. So, eat some food. Hopefully the ice cream in the boot, or is it my satchel? Satchel. Okay, eat that. This will be interesting because I need to be pretty, well, potentially need to be quick. Getting in there, grabbing it, and getting out. Depending on how many zombies are in the area. Pray the door's open. Yes, thank you. It normally is. And then just grab as much bourbon as you can. And a lighter, oh thank the Lord. It's a good amount. Five, bloody hell. Hello, come to me. Come to me. Yes. Want to see if there's a gas can? You never know. Bastard. 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 Fucking come on, son. Right. Getting ahead of myself. Parody off. stuff, so I'm nice and light. Equipped to your lighter, to your secondary, and Molotov cocktail to your primary. I might not even need it, but sometimes you do. Nice not to have to burn everything. I might actually be able to kill these fuckers. Sometimes there's a horde over here, so you've got to use a Molotov. But, not all the time. Bloody angles. I have found that when you're attacking zombies, sometimes the one on the floor will be held on the floor by another zombie that stood on top of him, so he can. Once you sort of see these things, like it's quite handy to help you fight multiple. As long as you get one to stand on the other, you can knock down the three to say two, and so on. But it's I think. Goodies we have in here. The crisps are handy because they're light. I tend to just stick them in the bum bag. Obviously I've got shit in there at the moment, but crisps and granola bars handy. Please be a how to use generators, that'd be fucking amazing. No, of course not. Empty gas can would be nice. That's handy. Yeah, the problem with going to the military base is brilliant, but it doesn't have gas pumps. So that's why I've always tended to go to like the gas stations, because you just get a hell of a lot of gas. It still obviously runs out after a while, but it's quite handy to have it so readily available. But I don't know, the military base has been quite interesting. So I've gone there previously in my other playthrough. My personal playthrough. And it's been going quite well, but it's just the gas is always a bloody issue. But we'll see how it goes. much gas as I can when I'm here. It's a bit nice and quiet. I like that. In my other playthrough, I had to use a bloody Molotov cocktail to clear everything out. So this has been blissful in comparison. Famous last words, though. Bottles at the moment. There should be a trauma bag, which would be very nice. Take that. Beta blockers I never use on. Just take the holder, the Saturn U. A regular tire to be good. But not that useful. Water gas can take. Okie dokie. Right. They're both over there, so that's alright. Fill up the gas can. Right, so that's good. So I've got as much fuel as I can get at the moment. I would like more, but... Oh, is that a car? Yeah, it might have a gas can. I'll go and have a look. Have a look and then go. next stop will be McCall's. Is it McCall's? McCoy's login place. See what I can find there. Cause I need a sledgehammer, really. Some more axes. Propane mask. Welder's mask, sorry, and a propane torch. Still need a how to use generators, but bloody good luck. What's in the back of there? Fucking bastards. Wanna do. But then again. Fucking prick. Okie dokie, right, off to the login place. please. This is enough piss ass in a night. Ideally, you don't want to damage your car. Easier said than done. Well, keep it as long as you can. Oh, fuck me. I'd normally go around the back because I don't want to draw zombies here, but seeing as I'm not going to be coming back here, I don't care if they come over here now. It's only going to be here once. Well, maybe twice, but I'd have to come back to go here again. It's a long way. So hopefully I can get what I can get now and not need to come back. Right, I don't have much room in the car now. Takes up much room, but it's all things you want. Food you don't want to just chuck away. Books you need for the long game. Five, fuck me. Alright, maybe not. Oh, what? What? Oh, shit. Taking the fucking piss. She's in the car. I don't need those and those. Not that they weigh fuck all, but still. Okay. Unfortunately, it means I can't take the bloody water dispenser. But there are plenty in the other area, so it's not a big deal. Right, okay. So, is there a car or anything? No. No. Come on, car, for fuck's sake. She's fine, it's everything, it's fine. Oh Jesus, the wheels. As long as they can get me to the army base, that's all that matters. better than the other one. The other one is fine, it's just... need more storage, really. A truck of some kind would have been best. Try and sneak around. Or be as quiet as you can anyway. Give me a bit of time to have a quick look. If it's just one out there, it shouldn't be too bad. He won't even break through or anything. So ideally you want a propane torch, welder mask, sledgehammer would be handy for the military base, and a wood axe. I'd give up all these fire axes for one bloody wood axe. Just gotta hope for open doors. Oh, please be open.
Yes.
these normally the good ones, but there's a lot of zombies. So this one is a good one. Okie dokie, right. Might have to burn these bastards. Can I lead them away? Stop running. Just walk. Alright, I've got to sprint a bit. Go around the back. Don't see me. Oh yes, okay. Right, fingers crossed, everyone. Take the water's mask. What was that? Wood axe, yes. I hear you, you little fucker. Propane torch, I did see it, it's over the other side. If I can get a sledgehammer, then oh, then whoa, ha, ha. Another welder's mask, I could equip that. Better be safe and have two. If I can find a sledgehammer, and then it's pretty much just like wood glue. Seeds are handy. Propane torch. Okay, I need you. I'll take two, is always handy. Watch my weight. Oh, fucking hell. Right, this is gonna be a bastard now. Right, attach that to your back. Be horribly over. Don't need that fire axe. Use the wood axe, perfect for cutting down the trees. You only ever need one, really. What's that? Heavy load, okay. So that's my back. Do I need the equipped crowbar? Because I'm pretty much just gonna walk over there, so I get rid of it and hopefully put it down to fairly heavy load. Nope. Bastard. I don't need to. It's just too much. They're great weapons, but they drain your energy so quick. You just use it to knock down walls. That's all you'll ever use it for, really. Well, in my opinion, anyway. It's fucking crazy. But it is powerful. Right, well, at least I know it's here, but it's coming back here. I can't see me doing it. Not for a long time. But like I say, one wood axe is good enough, especially if you get some wood glue, but that seems to be in short supply. Coming out to... going because I need to try and get to my next little resting spot before nighttime comes. Right, okay, so just fucking equip that then. May as well. Sprint if I need to, so that's good. Right, so yeah, I'll get to my car, drive to the next safe spot to sleep, which is it's a bit of a drive from here. I could double back to the other house I slept in last night, but seems counterproductive going backwards when really I need to be heading towards the military base. The sooner the better, really, because I want to get there when there's still power and water, because then I can make the most out of the TVs. Because if I'm actually going to sleep in the same spot every night, I'll sleep next to a television, so I'll always be there. Because I'm missing out on so much free experience by not being by a television every 6 hours. So I think early game is so beneficial. Cabbage seed is good. Right, now we just gotta hope to God the bloody tires don't pop off the car. Time to say goodbye to this place. Well, for now anyway. It'll be interesting trying to come back because getting out of here is pretty much a one-way ticket. Because by the time you're trying to come back, most of the trees have overgrown right up to the sides of the bloody road. Well, in the place where you need to go to pass these cars coming up, but unless you come back with an axe to cut the trees down and maintain it, or the propane torch to dismantle the cars, is pretty much going to be a one-way trip. But I will at some point. It's just that's not for a long time yet, because there's enough bloody buildings next to the military base to explore before you need to worry about coming back over here. If I could even get to the fucking military base, this is all in theory. Well, I say military base, it's more of a checkpoint, you know, but same difference. That's one section. I've always found it's easier to go around from this side than this one. Yeah, because that, you ain't getting past that. And then this one, you just go wherever you bloody can. By the time all this is overgrown, you ain't getting back there unless you dismantle the cars. Which takes time, attract zombies, so you need to be kitted up. Thank you. course. Fuck's sake. Oh, no, it's not worth it. Shit, I'm too overweight. It takes too long to fucking kill him. Bollocks. Running him over, potentially fucking up the one car I do have. So fucked, I need a new car. Oh, you fucker. Is it worth checking in there for the key? Because there's a good chance some of these keys are in. I don't know. I might just stick with this one. He's probably more fucked now, but as long as I can. He's with the time. Potential to come back here, though. Because it's not too far from the military base. It's still far, don't get me wrong, but it's not. Trader as well, fucking hell. Right, it might pay to hopefully come back here once I've got the base secure. But saying that, there are so many cars around the military base anyway. You might not even need to. The trailer is very nice though. It's not worth the risk to me. It's the bloody weight I'm carrying. Could put it in the trailer, learn the weight, and do it, but it takes time. Would it be in pitch black nights as well? As soon as it comes night time, you don't want to be like outside. get to the railway track, and then I'll cut off. Track does damage to your car, but I haven't properly checked it out. I would have thought it can be the most amazing thing for your suspension and tires, but at the same time, I don't know. I've never driven across it. This is where I want to stay for the night, ideally. So, I'm gonna have to kill these fucking zombies, they're gonna come up. So I'll drop this shit on the floor. I can check these cars out as well. Here they bloody come. Kill these two because there's a chance they could wander over during the night. Okay, made that three. Hello. There's so much clothes at the army base as well, you don't really need clothes. Winter clothes you might, but that's, you want proper winter clothes. Empty gas can, just my fucking luck. More stuff that I want to carry. Pardon me. I should take it, but it's just the weight. But it's not going anywhere, so that's one good thing. Can't get to it. will need. In a glove compartment. Now that's fucking crazy. Because that's not a hatchet, that's a big fucking axe. Right, ham still fresh, good. I don't really want to eat it yet. Ice cream before it goes blech. No, okay. Ah, fuck it. Right. That's pretty much everything I can do for the day. So I will sit in the car and read one of the books. Device options, hear something on the radio, or anything on the radio. You do get some crazy stuff sometimes on the radio. Right, finish reading mechanics. Right, so that's good. I don't think I can bring the map up while he's reading, unfortunately. But the plan will be tomorrow to basically head to the military base, which isn't too far further along the road. Draw them all out to the front of the base, burn them all, and then from there, just clear out the rest with the crowbar. And then we'll go from there, pretty much. See what goodies there is in the base, see what cars are out the front. And, yeah, then I do need to find a bloody how to use generators, because that's obviously a countdown once the power goes out. Oof, if I haven't got how to use generators, oof. That brings fun of its own. Right, pretty much, there ain't much else I can do, unfortunately. I will, however, learn from my last mistake and not burn my own bloody base down by running into the fucking fire like a pleb. I will. I can't believe I did that. I've been using barbecues since then, so it's a bit safer. But, yeah, that was very fucking stupid. Yeah. Not talk about. Have I got any other books to read? Just have a look. Farming is the ideally I don't want to go to sleep till about 10, maybe. Otherwise I'll wake up too early. I don't know how you fucking stop reading, other than starting the car. There's probably an easier, better way, but I just don't know it. Right, that's that. Windows are shut. Lock the doors. And pray nothing wanders along during the night. Fingers crossed. Right, guys? Thank you very much for watching. Hope you're enjoying it. It will get better as I get better. yeah. You all take care and see you next time.